Sometimes family history gets away from us. That's why knowing your ancestry is a true gift. Arlisa Robinson has often wondered about her roots and the side of her family where she had almost no information at all. Ancestry.com helped her find some answers, and tonight, Lisa takes us on her journey.
I have known about many of these faces all of my life. And with the help of this woman, Ancestry.com's family historian, Anastasia Harmon, I get a clearer picture about some others.
Your family has been one of the harder families that we've traced.
We met Harmon in Troy, North Carolina, at the home of my paternal great-grandparents, Thomas and Henrietta Patterson. I had been there as a teen. It was the last time I saw my great-grandmother. I was 17. She was 99.
This isn't what I remember.
This time, the home on Lovejoy Road wasn't easy to find.
And then Ohio.
Some longtime neighbors helped us.
So we're basically standing where they were living 100 years ago.
Census records show my great-grandparents were here in 1910 and living in this house when they celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary. It was documented in local newspapers. 8 of their 9 children posing with them in this photo that appeared in the Montgomery Herald. The census also shines another light on my heritage.
Something interesting that it shows here, this is the race column. Mm-hmm. So we see for Thomas that it, can you make that out? What that says?
He's mulatto.
Mulatto. And Henrietta is black. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of a hint about their ancestry. It's saying that there's white blood in there and that it's invisible.
Census records didn't have much on my great-grandfather Thomas Patterson's ancestors. But the 1910 census does show he was a sawmill laborer. Lumber was and still is a huge industry there.
It was very physical. I mean, it was a lot of work. The lumber was all sawn and everything, mostly in the woods and hauled to the mills to be dressed.
My great-grandmother was known as the preacher. She founded the Rose of Sharon Church of God in Christ Apostolic Church. Rosemary Huntley, the president of the Montgomery County Historical Society, met us there.
They were very well-respected people. They lived over in a section, really, where all the residents were white people, except them. And they were very good people. And the community loved and respected them. Mm-hmm.
I also met a cousin I've never even heard of before. She told me about my great-grandfather.
We call him Uncle Tom. He was a short man, very fair complexion, real curly hair, beautiful hair. Your hair made me think of him. And he would walk from Lovejoy Road to town, anywhere he wanted to go. And a lot of people loved him. But the black and the white would call him Uncle Tom.
From Troy, Harmon takes me about 40 miles south to Rockingham, North Carolina, in Richmond County, to the Covington House Plantation. Covington is Henrietta Patterson's maiden name.
We believe that this Covington Plantation House was either a property where your ancestors would have been enslaved, or that the people who own this plantation are related to the former masters of your ancestors.
Harmon says in 1860 in Richmond County, there were 300 enslaved men, women, and children owned by someone with the last name of Covington.
There were several white Covingtons in this area, and we believe that your ancestors were obviously owned by one of them.
Right. Harmon shows me the 1870 census. It is the first one taken after the Civil War, the first one after emancipation, and the first census that listed formerly enslaved people by name. Here I find my great-great-grandfather, Henrietta's father, Aaron, born in 1862. He's 8, now free, but still working in the fields.
I never knew what his mother's name was. Had no idea.
I asked Harmon to help me find out about my paternal grandfather, David O'Neill Robinson. He and my grandmother divorced early in their marriage. There wasn't much talk of him when I was growing up. As a matter of fact, my grandmother gave me this picture of him within months of her dying. She wrote on there, "Lisa, this is your grandfather," and that's all I got from her.
Although never confirmed, the family story is that David O'Neill was fathered by the white man his mother worked for in North Carolina. And that man's last name was Beatty, a common name in that area. And that's it. That's all I know. So when other people named Robinson ask if I'm related, I have no idea.
Harmon had some clues about the grandfather I never met. With my 12-year-old daughter, Grace, by my side, Harmon showed me this Social Security form. It said David O'Neill worked for the Consolidated Gas, Electric, Light, and Power Company in Baltimore, now BGE. He was born in Ivanhoe, North Carolina, in Bladen County.
He says his father is O'Neill Robinson and that his mother is Laura Andrews. Right. So some definite clues. Those are your great-grandparents. Mm-hmm.
A closer look at the records creates more confusion. On his Social Security application, David O'Neill says he was born in 1907. That would make him 3 when the 1910 census was taken. On that census, Laura Andrews lists herself as the head of household.
And she says she has 7 children living, but only 6 are with her.
Right.
So not only the question is, where's her husband, where's David?
Right.
Because David should be in this. Mm-hmm.
While that remains a mystery, I now know the name of my other great-grandmother, that Laura Andrews was born at the end of slavery in 1865 in rural North Carolina. And although I did not know her, and I don't have a picture of her, she looks like a heck of a woman on paper.
She can read and write as both of her older daughters can. Her children, including the 2 that are working out in the farm with her, are attending school, as are her younger ones of school age. Mm-hmm. She owns her home, free and clear, meaning it's not mortgaged, and it's a house, not a farm.
I have more than I ever had before.
The thing about family history is every time you find a clue, there's one more clue and one more thing to kind of piece everything together.
I started this journey knowing many of these faces, and with the help of Ancestry.com, I certainly have a clearer picture of who I am. Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News.
Lisa thanks the folks at Ancestry.com for their help. She's now working on her mother's side of the family, which dates back more than 100 years right here in Baltimore.